The work that I'll discuss relates to our long-term effort to understand how a protein called GATA2 controls the development and function of blood stem and progenitor cells that produce all of the blood cells required for life. We discovered a number of years ago two enhancer sequences that control the expression of the GATA2 gene and therefore dictate the levels of the GATA2 protein. If either of the enhancers are removed from the genome of a mouse, this results in lethality during embryogenesis due to failure to develop the blood system. In 2011, several groups discovered patients with a complex blood disorder that we now call GATA2 deficiency syndrome. And those patients have mutations in the GATA2 gene that change important amino acids or truncate the protein. At the same time, we were collaborating with Stephen Holland at the NIH and discovered that some of the patients have mutations in the enhancer that we discovered, the plus 9.5 enhancer. These findings provide the basis for the current study to investigate how the GATA2 enhancers and their disruption cause human blood diseases. The most common human enhancer mutation is a single nucleotide change in the plus 9.5 enhancer. We used CRISPR-Cas9 mediated genome editing to engineer this mutation into the genome of a mouse. We then conducted a variety of studies to ask how the human disease mutation impacts upon development of the blood system and function of blood cells in the developing mouse embryo and in the adult. The major discovery was the enhancer mutation from the patients had no impact upon blood cell development in the mouse, and embryogenesis was normal. In fact, even the adult mice were essentially normal. However, when we introduced a stress into the hematopoietic system, specifically we used a chemotherapeutic agent, 5-fluorouracil, that kills cycling or dividing progenitor cells and forces the hematopoietic stem cells to regenerate the blood system. Then we found a major defect in regeneration and, in fact, lethality in some instances. Under these conditions, the disease mutation caused a drastic change in the transcriptome of the blood stem and progenitor cells in the bone marrow. And strikingly, in the normal context, in the steady state, the disease mutation had essentially no impact upon the transcriptome. So this study, in essence, describes how the human disease mutation segregates the developmental versus the regenerative functions of an essential transcriptional enhancer. Our study provides strong evidence that the human mutation is a predisposition mutation that requires a secondary insult, either genetic or environmental, to trigger the onset of disease. The mouse model that we've created provides a unique system to discover strategies to oppose the process, the triggering process, where a relatively silent mutation becomes pathogenic. It is likely that many of us harbor predisposition mutations. But our genome sequences are not known in most cases. And even if they were, there are major obstacles associated with reading the significance of genetic variation in genomes. This is a very important area for future investigation, with implications extending far beyond that of blood diseases.